I think there's certain things in our Christian lives that we got to be reminded of every now and then. Otherwise, we just don't do it, you know. And so the Bible says in Romans 12, we got to renew our minds. Ephesians 4:23, be renewed in the spirit of your mind. So we got to renew our minds as well as the spirit of our mind. The spirit of our mind means the atmosphere in which we're thinking. We got to keep on renewing it, keep on renewing it, keep on renewing it, you know. So a good way is to listen to the stuff that I keep on speaking about like two or three times a year. But in Isaiah 28 verse 12, there's a verse that says, with other tongues and stuttering lips and stammering tongues will I speak to this people, and yet they will not listen. Okay? So God says, I will speak to people with tongues. Okay? And that is Isaiah 28 verse 12. Then in 1 Corinthians 14 verse 20, I think, 2021, this scripture is quoted. Maybe I should, I've got it in 1 Corinthians 14. I'll read it to you in the English Standard Version. I think that's, I just picked it up now, so let's read it. It says, verse 21, in the law it is written, by people of strange tongues. I love that one. Everybody says strange tongues. Right? People of strange tongues. And by the lips of foreigners will I speak to this people. And even then, they will even not listen to me. I mean, that is a stubborn lot of people, okay? So God says, with strange tongues. I love it because that same chapter, Isaiah 28, says, strange is the workings of God. And then when Jesus started doing miracles there in Luke chapter 3, the people said, we have seen strange things today. So I love strange things. Okay, so if you start getting accustomed to church, it's not church anymore. There must be like strange things happening in the church of Jesus Christ. So it seems like tongues is very important, and by it all, it seems like strange tongues is very important to Jesus Christ. So much so that he says, I'm going to speak this way. And yet if I speak this way, the people that I've taken out of the land of Egypt, trying to bring them to the promised land, they still will not listen, even if I speak to them strange tongues. Say strange tongues. Okay? So somewhere this had to be fulfilled, because we never saw it in the Old Testament. God spoke in a tongue that people could understand. But then in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, God says, you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Power. Somebody. Okay, so when the Holy Spirit comes, the thing that we're going to get is power. So the Holy Spirit, okay, the Holy Spirit's going to come, we're going to receive power. Then in Acts chapter 2, the Bible says, and they were all with one accord in one place, because Jesus said they had to go tarry in Jerusalem. So they were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there was a sound from heaven like a mighty rushing wind, filled all the house where they were seated, all filled with the Holy Ghost, and started speaking in. Okay, what tongues? Okay, so we have strange tongues in another translation, and then we have diverse tongues in another translation. No, it's not diverse. Okay, diverse don't speak tongues, they say glug glug glug. Okay, in other words, strange tongues, diverse tongues. In other words, not one was the same. It was all different type of things, okay? So, just for the fun of it, that means ununderstandable. Okay? Ununderstandable. Ununderstandable, if there's such a word. Is there such a word? If it wasn't there, we made it up now. Okay? It was, thank you, English language, we'll put this in your dictionary. Ununderstandable tongues, okay? So then the Bible says, and people came from all over, and they streamed to this place, and they were bewildered, and they were amazed, and they said, what can this be? What can this be? But it was prophesied in Isaiah 28. This is how God's going to speak. Yet they knew the law, and yet they said, what can this be? And then they said, how is it that we hear them speak in our own tongue? So verse 4. How come they spoke in other tongues, strange tongues, diverse tongues, ununderstandable tongues, okay? Then in verse 4 it says, how do we hear them speak in our own languages? Yeah. Now, for those who don't know, that is verse 6. Now, verse 6 and verse 4 is two different words. Verse 4 is the word in the Greek that says glossolalia, which means ununderstandable. Yeah. They spoke in tongues that were ununderstandable. Verse 6 says, how do we hear them in our own language? And there we have a Greek word, dialecto, which means a dialect. In other words, they could be understood, okay? So they didn't speak in understandable tongues. They spoke in strange tongues, but the people heard them in dialects. Because if you read it, there were hundreds of different tongues. Partners, meters, from all different nations in Rome and in Italy, and they all string together and they heard different tongues, but yet there were only 12 people, that 120 and then 12 and then 11 and then 1 that eventually spoke, but yet the people heard them. So God interpreted for the people. So it's two different type of tongues, but strange tongues is so very, 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 very important, okay? So why do I want to speak on this again? In 1973, I was working in Johannesburg in Kempton Park, and somebody invited me to a church. I will not go into the details, but I wasn't serving the Lord Jesus Christ. I was far away from God, very far away from God, okay? So I went to church with no shirt, with very big trousers. They called bell bottoms. It was very wide, which was blue, with a green jacket, with yellow shoes, with very long hair, with a big peace sign around my neck, about this size. That's how I went to church, okay? So it wasn't funny. It maybe was funny, I don't know. But they were praying in that church. It was a prayer meeting. So at the end of the prayer meeting, the pastor said, would we all come to the front tonight, And people started up, and the guy that took me to church said, conquest, So I got up and I thought, this is so boring. Look at, So I was counting the lights in the roof, a big chandelier, like these little candles they had in the Pentecostal churches. So I was counting the lights, and then I counted the bricks on the side of the wall just to get the time over because it was really boring. And so when I came to the front and I started crying and I started weeping, and I thought, my goodness, why am I weeping so much? And I felt so sorry about my sin and I felt sorry about my bad life, but I couldn't speak. I just wept and wept. And I felt, these people are going to feel embarrassed because I weep so much. So I got up and I started walking out. I thought, well, I'm going to go to my car, And as I walked out, there was an old woman in the back, and she had a little card in her hand. Old card. You could see this card was handled. A small little card that she made herself, an old typewriter. And she called me like this. She said, young man, come here. God showed you to me in a dream last night. I must give you this card. And this card says 2 Corinthians 5:17. If any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And I thought, man, this card was given to me when I was just 7 years old. Somebody gave this card to me, and I remembered how I gave my life to Jesus. Man, and I started longing, when I was small, I loved Jesus, but now I'm far away, I'm not in hell yet, but I'm smelling like I was there already, So I took this card and put it in my pocket, and I went out, and then the church started coming out. And this guy said, hey man, we're going to drink tea at this one house. And we went to this house, flat there, very high, 7 or 8 story. We went there and we got there and I was still weeping, man. Nobody asked me what's wrong. I thought, it's all right, And they said, just before we get something to drink, shall we all pray? So we all knelt on the carpet and, I'm sitting on the chair. I'm not kneeling, what's this kneeling thing, And instead of praying, there was a young girl, and she started speaking in tongues. Now, I didn't know what it was. Maybe this is Portuguese people, maybe it's Italians, like the Pope. I thought, oh man, So this girl, then the woman starts speaking. Oh, God says, you know, this is an ocean and, you know, the waves are coming over your feet and trying to swallow you in. But as you walk deeper and deeper into the land, it becomes more and more rocky till you are on the solid rock. But if you walk into the ocean, there's more and more waves trying to swallow you in. And you got to decide tonight, are you going to let the waves of this world swallow you in, or are you going to walk deeper onto the rock and find a place? I thought, wow, that's nice. You know? So I wanted to say, like, thank you, or, you know, just nice, you know, something. And I opened my mouth, and I said, and that's how they carried me to the car that night. It's today, 40 years ago, and I'm still speaking in tongues.
Amen.
Huh? And God said, do you know that that is one of your power lines in your life? And so God taught me tongues before I said, Jesus, come into my life. I receive you as my Savior. Wow. And people say, oh, maybe you didn't get saved. Okay, in Acts chapter 10, Peter went to Cornelius' household. This was Italians. You know what Italians do? No, they say, Hail Mary, Hail Mary, Mother of God. Mother of God, would you please pray for us today? We want to get the salami and the spaghetti and the bolognese. Mary, Mary, in nomine Patri, Filii, Spiritus Sancti, Mary, Mary, okay. Okay, this is Italians, huh? So Peter went to this Italian house and he spoke. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 10, verse 44 through 46, and while Peter yet spake, the Holy Spirit fell on them and they spoke in other tongues. And then Peter baptized them. Nobody said anything about saying, Jesus, come into my life, forgive me my sin. And then the headquarters were very upset and they said, how could you baptize Italians? He said, how couldn't I? They spoke in tongues. In other words, tongues is a sure sign that something powerful has happened to you by the Holy Spirit that came upon you and in you. Somebody help, okay? So we gotta do it. So I've got the English Standard Version here today. So I'm gonna read a few scriptures. It says in verse 2, for one who speaks in a tongue speaks not to men, but to God. For no one understands him. You see, people will say, why would you speak those tongues of yours? Nobody understands it. Say, the Bible says it. Exactly. Can you read English? My Bible says, if you speak in a tongue, no one understands him, but he utters mysteries in the Spirit. Oh my. So, can you read English, sir? So, if I speak in a tongue, nobody understands me. It's ununderstandable. Yet, I'm speaking in the Spirit and it's mysteries. Mysteries, and the old King James Bible says, I speak unto God. Okay? Yeah. Capital God. So I love to know the mystery. So Paul writes over and over in the New Testament the mysteries of the gospel. He says, it unto us it's revealed the mysteries. So if I want to understand the mysteries, I need to pray in the Spirit. I need to pray. If I read my Bible and I struggle to understand it, I immediately switch to channel Spirit. So if I pray in the Holy Ghost, my mind and my spirit doesn't work together. So I can read with my understanding, yet I can pray in the Spirit. So I can read there. Wow, what on earth is this saying? Then I start making notes. And while I make notes, I pray in the Holy Ghost. Okay. Very easy. Everybody. Okay? 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 Now, you speak out loud in your native tongue, English or Afrikaans. Or Xhosa, or Pedi, or Sotho, or Tswana, or Ki Itumela, Engawela, Amaha, Ki Kunda Kajesu, Naha Ketela, Mongkobaha. Okay? Whatever. But while you speak, you know, say, I've got a white rat at home. His name is Kitimichiki. I've got a black cat at home, and he don't love my white mouse. Say anything you want. Say, I've got a little dog. He's a puppy, and his father. Just speak. Okay? While you speak, try and count up what you get there. Try and do something. Okay, speak. But you must speak out loud in your understanding. Okay? You can't. Now, speak in tongues. Speak in tongues and add that up. Who got that right? So your understanding and your spirit doesn't work together. It's two separate things. I can talk and say, you know, if I exercise myself and I take time, after a while I can maybe count this up. But not straight away. But if I speak in the spirit, it's very easy to kaboroko shikiti and count it up. Do additions, okay? It shows me that there's power, there's two different worlds when I speak in the tongue. It's mysteries unto God, okay? So let's go on, okay? Verse 4 says, the one who speaks in a tongue builds up himself. Now, I know this stuff, I have to quote them, but I just want to read them today, okay? So verse 2 says, you speak mysteries unto God. Verse 4 says, you build up yourself. You edify yourself. Okay? When I was at my sickest, I couldn't pray. I really couldn't pray. There was no strength in me to pray. There I was lying in a secluded, you know, what they call it, room, you know? ICU. They're in ICU, but a separate room in the ICU. And I thought how Kubis brought Bobby Legere there from the United States and said, Uncle Bobby's here all the way from America. They prayed for me, I realized I couldn't even speak to Bobby, you know? But I was lying there looking at him and I realized I was going like this. When they left, I couldn't pray. I couldn't say thank you, Jesus. I was too weak. So I was lying. But I couldn't speak it out loud. And God says, because your spirit was constantly in contact with me, it just could not be separated from your body because it's Christ in you, which is the mystery. Okay? So if I speak mysteries and the mystery is Christ in me and I keep on speaking in tongues, something great and wonderful is happening to me. So, and then I thought back, we were in Carltonville and Sean was in our church there. And I remember I preached this sermon. TV just came out. It was still fresh. It was like 4 years old. All right? Yeah, there was no TV in South Africa. Okay? So 1975, the first TV came to South Africa, a black and white TV. Like South Africa. Okay? It should have come out later, but it came out earlier. But it was a black and white TV. Okay? In other words, there was no color on it. And here, in 1978, it started becoming a little bit color, but you could only pick it up in Johannesburg, okay? And in certain areas where there was big areas. And they had an ad on TV, okay? It was in the drive-ins and in the bioscopes, but then they threw it now and then on TV. It was the only ad on TV. And it was like this old man was sitting on a bench in a park, and he was sitting there, And there came another old lady, and she sat next to him. Old, ancient. And the one asked the other one, "So how old are you?" He said, I am now 45. And then he said, "If you're experiencing a midlife crisis and things are too much for you," and then the one guy pulls out a pocket of pills, a box of pills, and offers it to the other one. And it says, Salusa 45. And he offered it to them, and they put it in a glass, and it was sparkling, and the guy drank it, and he jumped up, and he said, "I already feel so good. Salusa 45 to strengthen you in your midlife." And I thought, yo, they're ancient, and Salusa 45 strengthened them. And I took that ad and I took it to church. That was 1980, 81. And I remember there was this little benches. It had no rear sides, you know, where you can rest on. It was a Boy Scout hall, a Girl Guide hall. And I went and lied and I said, "If you're experiencing in your 40s, you can't make it anymore. Don't take Salusa 45. It says, and I said, "The world wants to get stuff in you. They want to put pills in you, inject you, drink some energy drink, inject some injection. They want to put stuff in you to make you strong." God says, you got to get something out of you to strengthen you. Because out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. So if you let the Holy Spirit come out, so it's not so much the stuff that you put in that's going to give you energy. It's what you take out of you that gives you energy. And I thought, I preached that when I was 28. And I said to the people, you know, as you get older, keep speaking in tongues. It'll always energize you and keep you young. That was when I was 28. And I thought, my goodness, I'm still preaching, speaking tongues. It edifies you. And God said, this is part of you staying young, keeping you young, energizing you. Keep on speaking in tongues. So start when you're young and don't stop when you're getting older. You know, it seems like people speak in tongues, oh, when there's certain music playing in the church. You go to certain churches when there's good music. Man, when the music is right, they start shaking. And then they start. Okay? The ladies can do it very good. Has anybody been in a church like that? Come on, be honest. Anybody ever? No. Nobody. Nobody. There's men also in those churches. They karaba shakalamaka taralamaka shakatalalama. That's how it sounds. They all speak the same tongue. Rakaba shakatalamaka shakatalalamaka takalama. It sounds just, you can record me. It sounds exactly like that. Africa is full of it. Switch your TV on. Sounds the same over and over. It's got to be different. It's got to be strange. It's got to be diverse tongues. You got to hear. There's an articulation. There's falls and rises. There's full stops and there's climaxes. You got to understand it's a language. Okay? If 10% gets it, we're going to have power. It mustn't sound the same all the time. It must El Brando Bobra Spera Halovria in Blagadish Candeleiro Mendraguvla Har Espregadula Castanere Riquete Sperto Tukla Shikita Kuhuda Mata. If you exercise yourself and listen when you speak, you will hear that I will empower you every time you open your mouth. Open it and I will fill it. And I will give you languages that will give you understanding in the spirit realm and not in the realm of the flesh. That's what I just said now. But you got to practice. You got to exercise. Like we were in 1 Corinthians 14. I hope somebody's got to get something somewhere. Okay? Verse 13 says, therefore, one who speaks in a tongue should pray that for the power to interpret. Okay? How many speak in tongue? Now it says, if you speak in a tongue, you should pray for the power to interpret. Right now. Say, Lord, give me the power to interpret. Come on, do it again. Power. Say, Lord, give me the power to interpret. Many times I would, you know, speak in tongues, prophesy. Speak in tongues, prophesy. Many times I think, I'm just going to prophesy. Then I stand up and I start prophesying, you know, and it all rhymes. But I can do it in tongues too. You know, so if you speak in a tongue, you should pray for the power to interpret. So, valgaramaskade. You're gonna be enclosed with power of light, and you're gonna put everything to flight which is of the night. So rise up in power, take it this very hour, speak the word out, let it come forth. Let there be power in this hour. Speak it forth. Let it come from the south and let it go to the north. Something like that. Just go for it. Okay. So let's go. He says, for if I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my mind is unfruitful. Does that mean I take my mind out of the way? Now, I've just proven to you there, my mind is unfruitful. In other words, my mind doesn't work like my spirit works. But it doesn't put my mind, it doesn't kill my mind. But it makes something unfruitful. What is fruit and what is unfruitful? Fruit is the fruit of the Spirit. What is the fruit of the Spirit? Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, kindness, meekness, gentleness, faith, temperance, that stuff. That is the fruit of the Spirit. So if it's otherwise, it's unfruitful. Okay? So in other words, I must kill the stuff that is unfruitful. So if I labroshikitikalaga, I will not be angry. I will not curse. I will not swear. I cannot say, you flippin' bidiba budiba halibid dilaha, you son of a second-hand snake. What must I say? Okay, so if I practice myself and somebody scares me or frightens me, I'm standing here thinking, oh, and somebody frightens me, and I say, oh, you know, and it's out. You say, well, it just came out. It means it was in. It means it must be there if it comes out, because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. But if somebody frightens me and I say, Racha shikala mo huka bo ra, bless you, you blessed thing. Try frighten me, try scare me, okay? I don't really get scared, but I mean, if you do, something like this will come out, bless you, or, you know, hallelujah, or, Sakelo moku bracha halaka. Yeah?
Amen.
It's quiet now. See, it's the exercise. You got to exercise your spirit. But listen to yourself. If you pray, pray in the spirit. Let's read on. It says, but what am I to do? I will pray with my spirit, but I will pray with my mind also. Old brother Kenneth Hagin used to say, he said, I get up every morning and I pray an hour in the spirit. He says, then I pray in the spirit and pray to interpret. He says, and then I pray my sermons out. I pray the mysteries out. I pray the wisdom of God out for the day. Son, you shall go to that store today. Yes, Lord. Rabo shihitike. You shall talk to Sister Sarah on the way. Rabo she ha. Yeah, Lord. Rabo she tiki. You see, Kenneth Copeland sometimes does it that he got from old brother Hagin. And this is what he did. He said, Levaracha mo koto shikite. You shall speak in Isaiah 28. Yeah, ro. Yes, yeah. Rabo ku na. Yeah. You shall go to 1 Corinthians 14. Yeah, Sabo, Romokoto, Shete. Yeah, maybe I don't do it that way, but I do it. And I realize that's how I pray. I pray and then I write, and I pray and I write, and I pray and I make notes. So I'm actually praying and interpreting all the time. Maybe I don't realize it, but I do it because I'm exercising it. So I love teleme and I make notes. That's awesome. I haven't got a Bible with me, but I'm making notes out of the Bible because it's the Spirit that wrote the Bible that's in me. You know? How come I make notes? You know, when I have scriptures and then I go check the scriptures afterwards. My goodness, it's true. You said, yes, I said it to you. I wrote it, so I know it. Yeah, Smith Wigglesworth said it. He said, I would many times quote scriptures. And I thought, but I never read that scripture. He said, I would say, the Greek would say that. He said, and somebody would say to me, well, how do you know Greek? He said, well, he that wrote the Bible knows the Greek, you know. He said, and then he went home and checked it out and it was right. And I said many times, and Lisa already asked me sometimes, I said, you know, if we could go to the Greek and you know, and the if I check myself, I've said this, and I've said it, and I've said it, and I've said it. If you speak in tongues, do you check yourself? Do you say the same things? Rabba shaka rakaba baraka shaka baka taka rabaka shaka tabaka. Yeah? Or do you train yourself not to start with the same word? If you train yourself not to start, this is my lesson, not to start with the same word, you will automatically say another word. If you don't start with karabasha every time, you will not every time say karabasha kalamaka talamasha kada. You will, you know, start with shalama for a second. Or talama, or Taliban, or no. I'm sure if I keep a tape recorder with me, I'm sure I speak tongues that I can go and understand. I listened to the previous Pope, John Paul. You know, I've got a CD of his where he spoke read Bible in 7 different languages, or quote scriptures in 7 or 8 different languages, you know. So I listened to him. He starts with Latin, and then he goes to Italian, and then he goes to Spanish, and, you know. So I listened to him, you know, I Signore, I Rebore. And I tried to follow him, you know. And then I start speaking. I wish I had a tape recorder. I'm sure I prayed in Latin now. I'm sure I prayed in Italian now. You don't have to say anything or get anything. But I try to be a tongue-talking Christian. I try to exercise myself. If I walk with anybody, you know? Ask Annalise, since we got married, ask my 3 sons, pray in the Spirit. When we get in the car, I said, just pray in the Spirit. Ask them if they travel with me or I with them. I come, just pray in the Spirit, you guys. Come on. We were in Cape Town with Chris and Peter there from Henneman, you know? And he started exercising it years ago by listening to me when I had a series on speaking in tongues in Valcom. And I heard him wherever we walk. Labo Robert Yishika. So the 2 of us are walking there, you know, Keta, Ka Bo Shika, through them all. Rabo Hokata, she la kaburene, indes perda la vita, mombrosa tuklavia istadela mumbru shikite, naka el chran elige blakurubaha. What are you doing? I don't know, but there's a lot of water coming from our bellies. And you know, by the end of the day, you feel so good. At night time, we're not tired. But if you neglect it, you know, what are we doing with what people say, Protestant people would say, well, that's the smallest of gifts. Why don't you go for the raising of the dead? Why do you want to raise the dead if you can't speak in tongues? It's as supernatural to speak in tongues as it is to raise the dead. Is it? Yes. Why don't you then speak in tongues all the time if it's not? But why don't you practice your tongues? Not five words. You know, a baby says, Papa, Mama, Papa, Opa, Oma, Sweetie, Nana, Poofy, Mimi. But when you're older, you learn to say, good morning, father. Hello, mother. You learn to say, hello, grandma, how are you? You didn't say, I went to the sea this week. You learn longer sentences. And when you're older, you can make a paragraph. And when you're older, you can make an essay. And when you're older, you can make a book. Come on, somebody. He says it in the same chapter. In the spirit, don't be children. But in the flesh, be children. But in the spirit, be mature. Listen, verse 20. Brothers, do not be children. Okay? In your thinking, be infants in evil. But in your thinking, that's talking about praying in the spirit than in the understanding. Be mature. In other words, I make myself mature in the spirit by block braha, loco mumbro, shiblabare, ele prevenito, subraba le kito. And God will remind me of things. God will reveal things to me. Mysteries will be open unto me. I will edify myself. Oh, that was still verse 4. I will build up myself. I will edify myself, you know? Oh, man. Tongues is a sign, man. It's Ephesians 6. Verse 16 says in the New English Version, it says, in all circumstances, take up the shield of faith. In all circumstances. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith. With which you can extinguish all the flaming darts of the evil one. Verse 18. Praying at all times in the spirit. Okay, have you got it? He says, in all circumstances, take up the shield of faith. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith so that you can extinguish. Okay, all the fiery darts of the evil one. Okay? So what has the evil one got? Fiery darts. Okay? Okay? Fiery darts. Okay? And they're coming to you. Okay? There you're running. Okay? Okay. Who's that? Are you too fat? Okay. Okay, there you are. Okay? Okay. That is a picture of art. I should put my signature there. Okay. I mean, you can frame it. Okay. Right. To extinguish the fire. It says, then pray at all times in the spirit. At all times. In all circumstances, lift up the shield of faith. At all times, pray in the spirit. All circumstances, all times. Not now and then. All times. Okay? So, I was in the tent. Long ago, 1986, 87, round about there. Okay? So, I'm walking there. Oh, man, I'm very spiritual. Whoo! Today, I'm going to do spiritual warfare. Father, in the name of Jesus, I cast off the darts of the enemy, and I've got the shield of faith. Man, I've got this picture in my room, you know, this armored guy. Darts, you shower. Man, and I feel so great. I'm getting so awesome. I'm a spiritual giant. You darts of the devil, you fiery dart. I cast you. Oh, my God. And I was becoming very spiritual. And I was about halfway down the aisle, and God stopped me. And this is exactly what he said. There's my wife, it's a long time ago. This is exactly what I said that Sunday. God stopped me and said the following. What on earth are you doing? True. I stopped. I said, I'm casting off the darts. He says, so where do you get that? And I stopped. And I was so disappointed. So I walked like this. True. My head dropped. And I walked to the front. Serious. And I went and I sat on the staircase in the tent. True. No, I'm serious. And I sat down. I was so disappointed in myself. God, what are you saying to me? I'm doing spiritual warfare and you stop me. Say the devil now, come. I mean, then there's nobody to stop him. And I was caught up in the spirit as I was sitting there. And I saw this gray cloud with an orange lining. Gray and orange. And in it were different words. Depression, oppression, fear, anxiety. And these darts came. And I saw these people walking in the street, and these darts hit them, and they were thinking, I should go in there. And they went into different shops that are not right, and they started doing wrong stuff, and darts, you want to smoke? Yes. Into the shop, buy cigarettes, smoke. Another dart, buy that book. Ooh, and they go in, buy the wrong book. Another dart, go into the video shop, get the wrong video. And why are people, God says, it's darts. It's fiery darts. It's thoughts coming into their lives, and they haven't got the shield of faith. And I saw somebody else walking. You know, and I saw water. And I saw the shield all around him. And I heard. All the fiery darts just being quenched. And this guy just, go tell that guy about Jesus. Excuse me, sir, do you know Jesus? See that sick guy, go pray for him. Woo, Rambo, can I pray for you, please? So what's the difference? Jude verse 20 says, beloved, building up yourself on your most holy faith. So it goes together with that verse. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Beloved, building up yourself on your most holy faith. We're not going to go before we all pray in other tongues. Not the old one. And then we're going to exercise ourselves to pray in other tongues. So God spoke to me last night and said, this is one of your lifelines, is you've been speaking in tongues. There's the prayers of the saints. There's the word of immortality. But you can bet on it, one of the lifelines is that you are constantly speaking in tongues. I had an accident here on the road, 2nd October 96. And I was speaking in tongues. And when the ambulance man, you know, took me into the hospital, you know, after cutting me out of the car and breaking the car doors open and stuff, they took me and they said, you know, his mind is gone, you know. He's saying this funny stuff all the time. Like, kapisho, ta, kila, mo, bra. He's speaking funny stuff. It's not his mind is gone. You know? I was labore, shiti, ka, telemenda. Because I was top of unconscious. But my spirit wasn't. Lambra shitik, it's got nothing to do with my mind. Salabo broshi. It's shield of faith. It's quenching the fiery darts of the enemy. It's building up myself on my most holy faith. Go light a cigarette and spray. Lebra shito la maha ruha rekabashi. Reboja. Rebahanala shiti ha. You will not smoke long. You have a stick boom. Gaan opgooien. Gaan rondrollen, skreeuwen. Come on, kill sin, man. Kill unrighteousness. Quench the fiery darts of the enemy. Pray in the Holy Ghost. I'm not praying your old tongue, your karabasha kalama. I'm talking about in the spirit, from your belly. Bom brevispe, eti kile mum brachale kito ku. Come on, let's all stand. Le brosite kalanaha. This is so important. Come on, everybody. Let's pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on. Not your old one. Try new tongues. Ask God for other tongues. Come on, exercise. Listen to yourself when you speak. Do put some effort in this thing, people.
Perto mondo l'estaria chitelabiro, le crovura la mongro duce bleca tera, erpando ruha la mohu kuduce, repredice la duria la mancanda la cagester da lira bondora, ora bossa catelia che rindo, bachanari esterda la vucadura. You in your house, let's cause a revival all across our nation, our continent, and all across the world. Repoto sanaria icherda la vice, pratedeiste erta tuce, le pratetuce tindelari istaria sestora la burda deito, reprodare stiltro tutura mobra, tecataria estotura la bucra duce che teleira, erpachalaco rocotuce, le protombro tus perda la dicheto caruce membra di telo. Thank you.